Well, it came a little bit late, but for sure this was her best event.
Her American Cup is over. Back to Fabian Hambuchen. And he has not looked like we have seen him in years past.
You know, he had a trip to Japan, actually, for 3 weeks. Spent 3 weeks over there. Said sometimes he needs a break from his father, who he considers the best coach in Germany. But he goes over to Tokyo every year, trains with national team athletes, says it's a good break.
Says his dad is sometimes too ambitious. And this is a very ambitious high bar routine. Hopefully he has watered down this one with a full twist. Fabian can get the job done on high bar. Without a doubt, he is a world champion on this event. 2007, he was exploding, won the high bar, was second in the all-around. Went to Beijing, figured to have a haul of medals. Came home with only one, a bronze, which for him was a major disappointment. Boy, he's tired, don't you hear him?
This is long.
Yeah, he's exhausted.
Sehr gut. He saves his best for last. Nothing gets the crowd going like the high bar.
He knows it. They like that kind of stuff. They want to see the guys fly.
They want to see a show. One last warm-up on this one last rotation. We'll see if Rebecca Bross can put this one away. What lies ahead for Rebecca Bross and her coach is one floor exercise routine to clinch the 2010 Tyson American Cup. Al Trawick back with Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegelin. At the last World Championships, Tim, she had a major mistake on floor exercise, which probably removed the gold medal that seemed as though that she was going to get. When you have a major mistake like that, can you completely erase it when you're about to do almost the same thing here?
Absolutely not. You know, you can try with all your heart, but here it was. This was the last piece of gymnastics that she had at the World Championships. She just needed to go out there and get through. That's it. But watch the legs buckle here, and she just pounds into the ground, and that made her not a world gold medal, but it made herself settle for silver. But remember, it's not such a drastic thing, because her teammate Nastia Lukin, the World Championships first part of the quadrennium, did the exact same thing. Silver medal.
What's your take on that mistake,
Elf? My take is she's coming here with a brand new floor routine, so she's not going to be too reminded of it too much. But Rebecca was very upset by that mistake. It was the first question we asked her when we arrived here in Worcester, and she said, no, I wasn't happy with it. She's a perfectionist. She will absolutely make sure that that type of mistake will never happen again. It was a costly and valuable lesson.
Yeah, I mean, we hear athletes all the time sometimes say that to learn how to win, you need to learn how to lose. And when you have a mistake like that, sometimes that feeling can really drive you.
But you know what? The thing about it is she has changed the dismount on floor just a little bit. But technically, mechanically, it's really the same thing. I might have shifted the order or something a little bit.
Here's Jessica Lopez from Denver and representing Venezuela.
cannot be the most difficult routine, but what I'm impressed with is the focus that she's brought to the choreography. She's come a long way in a year. Great maturity, paying attention to the detail of her floor music. It was beautiful.
Yeah, she doesn't look like the same gymnast.
Awesome.
Okay, we have a King of the Hill format in progress, meaning the leaders will go last. So Fabian Hamburgen, who just rocked it on the high bar, got a 15.5. So right now, he has the lead. Jonathan Horton needs a 14.2 or better to take the lead away from him.
Very doable. Remember, John, silver medalist at the Olympic Games in 2008. I said it then and actually have gone back to watch the two routines, Zokai from China, who just barely edged them. I think Jonathan's routine was more exciting, as you will see.
Come on now.
So here it goes. Big time release. Watch this bit.
Come on.
Nowhere near done.
Good, come on.
Saves his hardest one for the last, right here.
Back. Good. Come on, keep working.
Lock up.
Come on.
So John's capable. Come on. On a triple twisting double layout. Doesn't look like it.
Took the easy way.
So much time alone in the gym to have a moment like that with the crowd. So here we go. In first place after the third rotation, Rebecca Bross.
So remember that pass that she fell on at the World Championships that cost her the gold will be her final tumbling run.
Brand new music and a brand new routine.
Yeah, it's great. It absolutely, you know, every once in a while you see a routine where the choreographer just hit it perfect. This fits Rebecca Bross exactly. Yellow flag, out of bounds.
Big 1.5 cushion.
smile.
Good job. Nobody likes the music, Valerie.
I think it's going to work.
Oh, that was a good choice. Okay. All right, not again. Me too. Very good. She had too much energy on the front pass. She was flying in the sky. All right, good job.
You know, she's not the type of gal that smiles all the time. She's very serious about her work, and that was a great exercise.
Jonathan Horton got a big number, 15.35. So for the moment, he's got the lead.